Asawana.
The Supreme Egbesu Liberation Fighters. The Supreme Egbesu Liberation Fighters. The Supreme Egbesu Liberation Fighters. We are here to give the Nigerian government a piece of very important information. Also, we are using this medium to call the international community to bear us witness on this very critical issue that are bothering us as a people. Greetings to our patriotic, courageous, and selfless liberation fighters across the Niger Delta region. As your leader, I am assuring you once again that your effort and sacrifice will never be in vain. To the family of those who lost their beloved brothers, fathers, and sons in the course of this Niger Delta struggle, our sincere condolences to you all. Our hearts are with you. We are saying it categorically to you that the ideologies that your brothers, sons, and fathers stood for will be actualized in the Niger Delta region, because that they were never alone in the struggle and can never be died in vain. To the Nigerian government and its leaders, be informed that the Niger Delta region is never a conquered land for any man born of a woman. It did not happen during the time of our forefathers, and it will never happen in our own time. Over the years, the Niger Delta people have made frantic efforts to create an enabling environment that can promote business activities and subsequently bring the desired development that the people has been yearning for and promote the living standard of the people. But to our greatest dismay, the Nigerian government over the years have decided to handle the issues of the Niger Delta region with kid gloves. They have betrayed the struggle and have left the people to their fate. The once fertile agricultural land and marine environment has been completely degraded with series of environmental pollution through the oil pollution that has been taking place. Look at the outcome of the amnesty program for the agitators from the Niger Delta region. After accepting the amnesty pact and believing that the region will experience rapid development and transformation, till date, no school, no potable water, no light, no hospital, and access roads for our people to enjoy. Rather, what is visible as an individual achievement is the presence of military gunboats and the numerous military personnel dispatched to the Niger Delta region, which are raping, killing, and maiming the innocent people of the region. They have put serious fear in the minds of our elderly people because they are no longer safe in their own once peaceful communities. All for the government to take over our commonwealth from our resources. Look at the security surveillance contracts taking place in our region. Through the federal government and its agencies in place, they have decided to shortchange our people. Now in our territorial waters, it is an Israeli company that is providing waterway security, which we have competent hands with expert knowledge to manage and provide short security services. Look at the likes of Ocean Marine Solution providing pipeline surveillance contracts in a territory that has more than enough capacity hands to handle such contracts. Take a look at the Ogoni cleanup, just because it is a solely Niger Delta project. From 2011 till date, after the establishment and taking off of the project, no meaningful progress has been made because the government of Nigeria have decided to place politics above meaningful development of our people and the region at large. More than 100 staffs were unlawfully discharged from work in IPREP because the employee were majorly Ogoni people for the Ogoni cleanup. Look at the oil and gas sector and what is happening today in the gold mining sector in the Zamfara at the northern region part of the country. While the local mining licenses are being given to locals and state governments, having full control and management of the entire affairs of the sector. But in the Niger Delta oil and gas sector, the federal government have decided to cut away all our wealth and decide to give us peanuts. Please allow us to manage our resources the way Zamfara gold mining sector is being handled by their own people. There is always a saying that what is good for the goose should also be good for the gander. We are not second-class citizens of this country. We are full-blooded Nigerians. And if you believe, and the federal government of Nigeria believe that we are part of Nigeria, we should be treated the way it ought to be treated. And we should be given the fair share of what belongs to our people so that our elderly and our younger generation will enjoy and be good. Boko Haram terrorist group is ravaging the entire northeastern region of this country for over 7 years. And no single community has been raised down by the Nigerian security organization, especially the military, for suspicion of terrorists being from such communities. But in the Niger Delta, suspected sea pirate activities in the region has led to the raising down of our communities, and over 100 of such communities are in record. The same military that ought to provide properties has turned themselves into militaries of killing, raping, and maiming innocent individuals and rendering our area and our youth jobless. Look at the interventionist agencies of our region. Through the federal government control and manipulation, the agencies today like NDDC is now a laughingstock before all and sundry. Agencies like PTDF have stopped funding our Niger Delta youth. Even those that were given funding are being starved to the point of so many others being not completing their projects. Even in terms of employment, our people are less than 5% in the entire staff population. Even PEF, Petroleum Equalization Fund, the NNPC, the NPDC, and our PIMS, as all the rest, so many others have decided to treat us in the same manner. Don't worry, because we are coming to destroy all your infrastructures in Abuja and Lagos. Even to the oil companies operating in our region that have decided to undermine our people, be rest assured that your days will soon catch up with you. Due to the insensitivity nature of the Nigerian government on issues that are bothering its citizens, today the country is in turmoil. Protests everywhere and strikes in several sectors. The end-sat process that took place almost crippled the national economy. It is among such ill treatments that gave birth to this unprecedented protest. Nigerian government ought to give our citizens good governance. Today, the various zones in the country are calling for division of the country called Nigeria. Nnamdi Kanu, we are using this medium to also call on you that in no distant time, we shall relate with you for the liberation of our people from the hand of the oppressors in Nigeria. There is always a saying, there is no peace without war. And also, if things doesn't go bad, things will never get better too. So as a group determined to give total liberation of our people, we will destroy all the oil facilities, both onshore and offshore. In no distant time, we will be seen to be crippling the Nigeria economy in no distant time as well. With our over 3 million support base of faithful and dedicated fighters, with our tools base and our assurance of IEDs that are in our disposal, and also with generals all over the clans and wards of the Niger Delta regions, and the well-coordinated guerrilla warfare plan that we have put in place, the Supreme Egbesu Liberation Fighters, whole priority about his people, and from the Niger Delta region, the development required must be achieved. We have made communication channel available to interface with the federal government again, and this time we are nominating former President Goodluck Ebele Jonathan as representative representing former leaders from our region. We are nominating Edmond Dakoru, the former Minister of Petroleum, as representatives from the elders forum and traditional rulers. And we are also nominating Yeso Wike of Delta River State as present leaders and politicians to mediate between the federal government and our group to bring lasting peace and the desired development to our people. However, as a serious body, failure from the federal government to send a delegation to us within the next 2 weeks, we shall swing into action by keeping ourselves busy with both upstream and downstream oil and gas sectors facilities in the Niger Delta region, like what we did at Ikarama oil field and the dual coordinated attack carried out at Goliba and Mashin Creek facilities at Nebe and Ogbea LGA in Bayelsa State. The Niger Delta people cannot settle for less, and we are going for a total resource control and not this 13% derivation formula that the federal government have used to shortchange our own portion of our wealth and natural resources. They said a word is enough for the wise. Asawana, 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 the Supreme Egbesu Liberation Fighters.
We are fighting for our freedom.
Among our coordinators, the generals that have really made series of sacrifice for the growth, promotion, and the well-coordinated achievement of this our movement, we are also using this medium to thank you, the likes of General River Lord, the likes of General Do For Die, the likes of General Beta Niger Delta is for sure, the likes of If They No Gree, I No Gree, generals all over the Niger Delta region. We are assuring you once again that our plans, our achievement, and the development of the Niger Delta region is paramount, and by the grace of God, we shall receive that. If that is not done, then we are going to have our own republic in no distant time. The Oduduwa Republic is at the corner to emerge. The Biafra is also at the corner. The Middle Belt are also agitating for their own country. The Niger Delta can never be left out. The Supreme Egbesu Liberation Fighters. The Supreme Egbesu Liberation Fighters. The Supreme Egbesu Liberation Fighters.
Music.
Thanks for checking out Symphony on YouTube. Please be sure to subscribe and like our videos for updates.